More than 30 years ago, our next guest auditioned for but did not get a role in the original Coming to America. But his long journey to Zamunda is complete. He plays a fierce African warlord with a deep and abiding love of dance in Coming to America. It is on Amazon Prime Video right now. Please welcome Wesley Snipes. Hey, how you doing?
What's up, Jimmy?
It's great to have you.
Great to be had. Great to be had.
I've always wanted to have you on the show. Boy, it's been a long time.
Always fun to be on your show, Jimmy.
Well, good. Here we are. How you doing?
Hallelujah.
Everything good?
Yeah, I'm doing great, man. Everything is going wonderfully, you know. I'm out here in Los Angeles, you know, handling business. Ask Sasha how them vaccines working I got to him, you know what I'm saying?
He's got a number of cell phones. I'll give you one of the numbers from them.
No. He got my number already. He'd be good. Be good.
I mentioned in the introduction that you were, you know, you auditioned for the role that eventually went to Eriq La Salle. How many callbacks did you get for that part? I'm sorry if you're just finding out about this.
Yeah, every time I hear that, it just irks me. Jimmy, it irks me so bad. Irks me so bad. Yeah, I think we went maybe 4 or 5 auditions. Me, Eriq La Salle, my friend at the time. I think Mario Van Peebles, who we ended up working with on New Jack City. And I went back for a number of auditions, man. You know, I thought I had it. Thought I had it locked in there, Jimmy.
Yeah.
And then I came up with a big L, B.
You know what?
Came up with a big L.
But that L has now turned into two L's have turned into a W.
A Kalishnikov. What did he do? It's a Kalishnikov. It's a pew, 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 pew.
You, by the way, you were fantastic in Dolomite also. And, I mean, you really were great in that movie. And it's so great to see you and Eddie together. How long have you known Eddie Murphy?
I don't know, maybe since 1989, somewhere going all the way back that far. You know, all of us were hanging out in New York. You know, we all New Yorkers, so... We were all hanging out in those days.
Where would you hang out with Eddie Murphy? Like, would you guys go somewhere? Or would
downtown,
Somebody's house?
Downtown, you know, a lot of great clubs in those days, you know?
Uh-huh. Wow.
Yeah, and then there was also the Midtown China Club thing, but, you know, Rick James talked about that enough, so I'm going to leave that alone.
He did, yeah. Were you there with those guys when Rick was hanging out with them?
Nah, man, I wasn't there. Who told you that,
Jimmy? Crazy?
Oh, Jimmy, I wasn't nowhere near that, man.
Didn't Eddie move to L.A. right around that time, right around end of the 80s or beginning of L.A.? You don't know?
I didn't get an invite, so I don't know.
You guys hang out with Stevie Wonder, which is, I mean, who's better to hang out with than Stevie Wonder?
Oh, Stevie Wonder is the grandmaster. Stevie Wonder is the absolute grandmaster. You are blessed anytime you can get to stand next to, near, by, look at Stevie Wonder.
I did an event with Stevie Wonder once, and he was so funny. And I have to say, it was one of the funniest nights of my life. I did not realize how funny he is.
Oh, yeah, Stevie Wonder is very funny. You know, he'll greet you in different accents. You know, depending on where he thinks you're from, he'll greet you like that.
Uh-huh.
So if you're from Boston, he might greet you, hey, was park the car? You parked the car yet, dear? You know? And then if you're from the Bronx, he might say, sup. You're like, yo, it's like that, Stevie? I mean, you gangster like that? And you're like, oh, okay. Yeah.
What do you and Stevie talk about? Like, if you're in a typical conversation, what are the subjects?
Martial arts.
For real martial arts?
Yeah.
He's a fan of the martial arts?
No, Stevie Wonder is a grandmaster martial artist.
That's
why they call him fingertips.
I thought it was because of the piano. It's not.
No. He done laid him aside. You know, he's like, you know, there used to be a Japanese guy. They call him Zato Ichi. Yeah, and this was Zato Stevie.
Are you being serious? Does Stevie Wonder participate in the martial arts?
Jimmy, let me give you some words of advice.
Yeah.
Stevie Wonder will kick your ass. I'm trying to help you, man. I'm trying to help you. Stevie Wonder will kick your ass.
Because I know you are very accomplished in that area. Have you ever sparred with him or whatever you call it, where you get in and move around?
No, I can't say, Jimmy. Stevie right here, man. You know he won't let me speak on that.
Are you and Woody Harrelson still pals?
I hate that guy. I mean, I can't. I mean, if I see another Woody Harrelson movie, I'd like...
Now, that I definitely don't believe, because I do...
I love him so much, man. Me love him like cook food, man. Like, look, cook food, me love the boy.
Woody is a very competitive person. Have you experienced that side of him?
Oh, most definitely. In a lot of situations.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, you know, we used to play chess on White Men Can't Jump and, like, stall the production. Of course, we thought when they said 5 minutes, it meant 5 minutes.
Right.
But our 5 minutes was usually like 50 minutes because we went intensely into the game. No, Woody will compete on everything and everything and with everybody.
Yeah.
Handstands, backflips, running from here to there, jokes, you name it. He will definitely compete.
Who would typically win your competitions?
Jimmy, what kind of question is that?
I know, I'm wondering. The answer may well be you, of course.
Moi, Jimmy.
First of all, and people might think this is a joke, but it's true. Breakdancing is going to be a part of the Olympic Games. And
breakdancing, that's right. The breakers on rock, baby. That's right. B-boys rule the world.
You are involved in bringing attention to this, right?
Absolutely.
You were a breakdancer as a kid.
That's correct. My early days when I first started back in the Bronx in the early, when the Bronx was burning in the 70s, that's 76, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Yeah, man, I was on concrete. I learned how to flip on concrete. I learned how to spin on concrete.
This is before most people even knew what breakdancing was. Most people kind of figured it out in the early 80s. So you carried around a piece of cardboard and that sort of thing?
No. We had a crew, man. Cardboard was everywhere, man. Jimmy, the Bronx was burning, so there was plenty of cardboards in there.
After this weekend...
The goal is to elevate the art form. It's the first American art form that has ever been inducted into the Olympics.
Is that right? Really?
Yeah, man. Can you believe?
This is going to be a good Olympics, I can tell you right now. This is going to be a good one.
I'm telling you, and then what we're going to do is that we're going to expand it. We're going to put an Olympic training center there in the Bronx, and then we're also going to make the Bronx the sanctuary.
I love that idea.
It's absolutely necessary. We'll heal the world, we'll heal the community, and we'll get in shape at the same time. And let me tell you something, Jimmy. Anytime you want to step into the ring, baby, let's get it on, baby.
Oh, yeah.
I'm right there for you.
I'm more of a popper and a locker, but yeah, I would love to.
What's up, Jimmy? What's up? What's up, Jimmy?
This won't mean a whole lot to anybody until they see the movie. On Monday, everybody will be talking to you about this, but... Your character, General Easy, in Coming to America, you make a spectacular dance entrance every time you enter a room. And that is, I mean, I was that the plan going into this movie?
B-boys rule the world, man. B-boys rule the world. B-boys rule the world. Even in Nextoria, B-boys rule the world.
Well, the movie came out great, and you are fantastic in it. It's Coming to America. We've been waiting for it, and it is available right at this very moment on Amazon Prime Video. Wesley Snipes, everybody. Thanks, Wesley. Great to see you. We'll be back with Charlotte Lawrence. Thanks for watching. Remember, every time you click the subscribe button, one of your enemies gets destroyed.